We help to develop clinical trials and treatments for patients at every stage of cancer. A lot of our focus has been not just on actual therapies for breast cancer, but for understanding how patients are affected by a diagnosis of breast cancer. We work closely with our colleagues through our NCI Cancer designation, specifically with our group in Georgetown. And I've been leading up a program here looking at cognition or thinking in patients that are diagnosed with breast cancer. And in this way, we can develop and understand how potentially breast cancer and breast cancer therapies affect patients' cognition, and therefore hopefully develop a way that patients can deal with having a diagnosis of breast cancer on the long term. Right now, in our field of breast cancer, it's a very exciting time. Recently, data has been published primarily from December of 2020, looking at our ability to potentially avoid chemotherapy in a number of patients with breast cancer, whereas before, all patients with lymph node positive breast cancer would require typically chemotherapy after a diagnosis. Recent data, which we participated in when these trials were being developed, has shown that we can safely avoid chemotherapy now in a number of those patients. And obviously that's very important because we can still achieve the same excellent cures, but with much less toxic therapy. Other aspects that we look at within breast cancer are obviously treatments of breast cancer, and there are all different breast cancer types. So for example, a somewhat difficult or aggressive form of breast cancer is something called triple negative breast cancer, and we are looking at new or novel therapies for specifically triple negative breast cancer. We are also looking at developing new ways of monitoring patients that have had a diagnosis of breast cancer, looking specifically at something called circulating tumor DNA or liquid biopsies, which are ways of trying to pick up a recurrence of breast cancer earlier so that we can make an impact sooner and a more substantial impact. Research benefits patients every day, and I think that research now is at such an exciting time where things are moving from development in research to practically applying that much quicker than that's ever happened before. And I'm forever thankful to many of our patients who've participated in clinical trials, because that's the way we've really been able to take care of patients every day, and that's how our standards are developed.